So Jesus is up from the dead, is glorified. Is up from the dead, spirit, soul, and body. He is raised from the dead. And I want you to listen well. He goes to the dead with the scriptures. He's there. He's raised from the dead according to the scriptures. We've seen that again. Everything is according to the scriptures. Now, he's up again. And then I thought, will I just say, hey, Jesus is raised from the dead. Jesus is, you know, he's alive. Jesus is alive forever. He's alive. Amen. And he said, all right, I'm alive now. You know, he didn't come out like this. Oh, my God. Guys, you been to hell before? Said, no, no, Jesus. You just keep going. You know. And he go, oh. And he, let's do party. I'm alive. And they say, let's take another Passover. This time around, we'll kill cow. I came out alive. And everybody eating and drinking. For there not to be a celebration yet, the work wasn't done. He says, hold on. I ascend to my God and your God, to my Father and your Father. At this point, he is qualified to do what he was called to do.
The glory cloud is here, the power of our God.
Jesus has done everything. Awesome is your name. So if he has done everything, miracle, I just need to find out.
The mighty head of God.
Because the blood opened the way, not just for me to come before God. The blood opens the way for God to come into me.
Mighty manifestations. These are seasons of glorious manifestations. These are times of mighty manifestations of the glory of the Lord.
You are watching the Living Word Telecast. Okay.
Listen well. Amen. After 3 days and three nights. So he goes to heaven. That's what he said. I ascend to God. I ascend to my Father. He goes to heaven alive. Hallelujah. Now, I want you to open your ears now. He goes alive. He had defeated death in death throes. Yet, that was not redemption. He already had dealt with Satan. And yet, that was not. You see, we felt everything Jesus came to do was just to be fighting Satan. You know, no, he was done with Satan. In fact, Matthew's account was that how Jesus rose from the dead, or how Jesus died, and he rose from the dead. He said the graves opened up, and they saw visions of old time saints who were up, and they went to see, you know, their folks in a vision, and then they went back. There are a lot of people argue against that account, but there's no reason why it should be true. So he's up from the dead, yet the work is not done. Because he has to fulfill all that was written. Hallelujah. He should have gotten so excited and started resurrection convention. Come and see Jesus. Come and see Jesus. He didn't do that. Go to my God and your God. So he goes to heaven and he goes alive. He is alive. If he goes to heaven dead, then everybody will remain dead. He goes alive. Physically, he is alive. So what does he do? He ascends to heaven. And now, see, this is the error we get sometimes when we try to make the atonement look like the perfect description of redemption. The atonement is not the perfect description of redemption. The day of atonement is just an attempt. It's just at best. Because all the characters used there were faulty. An animal. A physical building. You can't get it right. An animal cannot do what Jesus did. But we can just dramatize it. You get what I'm saying here? So we always take the error. And that's why today you find people in their ignorance. They say because the high priest, when the high priest will come out, he will pour blood. I was in one service, and this great man of God, I think he's still great, he will always be great. But he brings tasty time. And I kind of felt this is getting too deep. And he says, I'm going to cover all of you with the blood. You know, I'm wondering, do you mean everybody here has the pages of the Bible, New Testament, torn? Because he said, just like the high priest will get up and he will pour blood on the people. So he took the tasty time with the ushers, carried it behind him, and he goes, shh. Everybody, now, I took up someone, I said, what's this ritual practice? Said, no! Our daddy in the Lord says it's a mystery. So, I don't like mysteries. I don't like mysteries. I like revelation. Hallelujah. So when they were going to start the festival, I walked out. And then the usher said, Where are you going? I said, I'm going home. He said, this is the most important part of the service. I said, that's where I'm leaving. Oh, if God will open your eyes. I said, never. So we're trying to dramatize it. Yeah, the blood. So maybe in our minds too, we think Jesus is like Levi. So when I say, Lord of Jesus, you see there's an echo already. You think just like Levi, Jesus has a basin with his blood. He's weak and tired. If all your own blood is in the basin, how are you going to walk? So it drips his blood. He has to use blood though. So Jesus carries things of blood, pints of blood. Where are you going? I go to my God. And your God. I go to my God. We already know that the Jesus didn't shed blood on the cross. Isn't that fair? So we also have to play the atonement. So we always say the blood. When we say the blood, in our minds we see Jesus carrying liquid blood. So Jesus shed his blood. Can I tell folks, if shedding blood means your blood oozing out of your body, then he did that 5 times. When he was circumcised, when he was born, of course there should be blood, doctors, I hope I'm right. If there's no blood when a baby is born, there you go. Mummified being. There's blood when a baby is born. Then when he's circumcised, Jesus was circumcised. You know, when he's circumcised, it's not the Holy Ghost that came out, it's blood that came out. Imagine the nurse saying, oh, the blood that was shed for me. Are you there? He was whipped by the soldiers. Whipped. Blood came out. So Salvation. We're very fast. How many places he shed his blood? When he was carrying the cross, too, and then they put the crown of thorns on his head, blood came out. And then blood came out of his head. So which of them is a shedding of blood? Problem is, we don't know what it means to shed blood. So we assume shedding of blood means you have an injury and blood is coming out. When blood is shed, it doesn't come out as an accident. It's an act of the will of the high priest. So if they're going to shed blood, it's not that they are shedding your blood. We thought Jesus' blood will be shed, but say, there will be blood shed in this place. So who did the blood shed? The soldiers shed his blood. So if you're going to shed blood, it's going to be done by you. Now, listen well. I took you through all the kindergarten, the Bible school. So let's get to the scriptures again. Now, open your ears if you're a student of the Bible. In the Old Testament, because of the kind of sacrifices, the blood took the place of the animal. Okay? In the New Testament, Jesus takes the place of the blood. Talk to some folks, but listen. Now, Jesus, when he died, was he dead? Sorry, I asked that. Did he die? Did he die? Okay. So if he died, he died. That means his blood wasn't flowing again. Or his blood was flowing for 3 days. Ah, see blood. See, please, power. This is deep. He's dead, but his blood is just flowing normally. He's dead. Okay, so if he was raised from the dead, was he raised from the dead without blood? He had no blood. He was not a human being again. You know, he ate food. You know, he ate food. You know, it's eaten before and after was not different. He was raised from the dead. What do you have there? Everybody says, we have bread. Bring it so that you will know that I'm alive. Bread, and bread say, Lord, I'm alive. Everybody will have taken to their heels. He ate normally. You know, if he was eating, crumbs would have fallen down. The crumbs now still in the air. Oh, he's alive now. He ate normally. So he rose from the dead and he is glorified. His body is up from the dead. So watch now. He now goes into heaven. Now, in the Old Testament, they killed the animal, and then his blood represented the sacrifice, because the animal was dead. So the other leg of that sacrifice or the ceremony was to now present an animal that is alive, because this same one cannot perform the same task. That is the death and resurrection. The animal couldn't be alive, so the animal will be dead, and then another animal, same goat doing one goat. Do you understand? All right. Now Jesus doesn't have to have a double. He's the same person. He had risen from the dead, and listen now. He goes to heaven alive. Resurrected, glorified. He performs the work of two things. The work of the high priest and the work of the sacrifice. And none of them in the new covenant will be dead. Listen now. Look at Hebrews 6. You know, where did the high priest take the blood to? Bible students, there is a secret. Behind the veil, right? Behind the veil. He takes the blood, he'll kill the animal outside, and then takes the blood into the veil. Now, Hebrews 6 tells us the same thing about Jesus. And what does he say? Hebrews 6 and 19. Which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, which sure and steadfast, which entered into that within the veil. Now look at 20. Let's take 20 together. Hebrews 6. Whither the forerunner is entered for us, Jesus made an high priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. So he goes into the veil alive. The blood of the bulls and goats of the Old Testament was to represent what he will do, because blood represents life. So he goes alive behind the veil. He goes alive behind the veil. He doesn't go into the veil dead. He goes there alive. He goes there as a son. Are you listening? Raised from the dead. Look at Hebrews 7 again. I'm going to give you a portion of scripture. Hebrews 7, verse 23. By so much, Hebrews 7, 23, was Jesus made a surety of a better testament. And there truly were many priests which they were not suffered to continue by reason of death. Now look up again. For the sacrifice to go into the holiest of all, it needed an high priest. Right? So there had to be an high priest and a sacrifice to go into the holiest of all. Are you listening? So that means the offering of Jesus' sacrifice and the priesthood or the high priest, they must go in together. Are you listening? Are you listening? They must go together. So, he is both the high priest and the sacrifice. Glory. So, he goes in, he says, and there truly were many priests because they were not suffered to continue by reason of death. This man, because what? Huh? He continues forever, has an unchangeable priesthood. Now, he couldn't be an high priest on the cross because he didn't continue. He died. So this has to be his resurrection. He continues forever. So he goes in, one, he is the high priest. Two, he is the offering he is taking there. Are you listening now? Are you listening? Good. So, Hebrews 8. So his priesthood and his sacrifice, both his priesthood and the sacrifice, will never cease.
The storm is brewing. Quietly. Yet. An outpour of God's Spirit through young men and women. This September, Campus Bible Faith Conference 2016. The Word taught, Spirit giving free course, Gifts of the Spirit at boiling point. Gift of ministers and ministries ushered in, reinforcing the word of faith with power on our campuses, Ghana, University of Cape Coast. The word and the spirit says, come.
Alive. That's why in the Old Testament they did it year by year. Jesus did it once and for all. That is once and forever. So Hebrews 8:1 says, we have such an high priest who is set on the right hand of the throne of the majesty, where? In heaven. Every time we mention or we hear about his high priesthood, he's always talking about where? Heaven. Hebrews 4:14. We have a great high priest passed where? To the heaven. So he did not fulfill his high priest ministry on earth. He did it where? So what does the high priest take into the temple? Blood. Sacrifice. Okay? So whatever sacrifice he was going to take, he had to take it to heaven. Hebrews 8, verse 6. Now hath he obtained a more excellent ministry, by how much also he is the mediator of a better covenant, which was established upon better promises. Present tense. Hebrews 9, quickly. He says in verse 21, moreover, the he sprinkled with blood both the tabernacle and all the vessels of the ministry. Hebrews 9, 21. And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. Now, shedding of blood simply means shedding of blood. It means to cleanse with blood. To cleanse with blood. Okay? It was therefore necessary that the patterns of things were, should be purified with this. But look at 23 again. Let's take it the B part together. But the heavenly things themselves with what? Better what? Now, the blood of the Old Testament was the blood of an animal that was killed. Are you there? Now, every time you read the word better in the book of Hebrews, it refers to something that is eternal. So what Jesus will offer has to be what will never see. It must be an eternal sacrifice. So he says, heaven will be purified with better sacrifices than this. Let's take 24 together. Let's go. For Christ is not entered into the holy places made with hands, which are the figures of the truth, but to where? In the heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God for us. Can you say amen? So Moses' temple was a type. Jesus goes to heaven. Now, at what point did he go to heaven? When he rose from? So at what point did he offer the sacrifice in heaven? When he rose from? Was he offering death or offering life? Thank you very much. That was a long journey for me. Offering life and not death. So what he offered in heaven was not death. What he offered in heaven was life. Hallelujah. This makes the new covenant eternal and the sacrifice eternal. Because he rose from the dead eternally. So whatever he will do will be eternal. Are you still there? He goes into heaven. Notice in the Old Testament, the priest will stand and then the blood will cease. Are you still there? The priest will stand, they'll first cover themselves with the blood, and then they will go in, and then the blood will sit on the mercy seat. So every time they turn to the mercy seat, they were going to receive forgiveness of sins based on the blood that is sitting on the mercy seat. It wasn't repentance that brought forgiveness for them. It was the blood that was shed. Without shedding of blood, there is no remission of sins. No matter if you cry your heart out, you got to shed blood. So they will take an animal and put the animal in their own stead. So the animal, okay, the animal's blood will now be the property, no, the atonement, Old Testament, for their sin, for 1 year. For 1 year. Now, Jesus, watch this. Jesus goes into heaven. Don't forget, the sacrifice will sit and the priest will stand. More than that, the sacrifice is for a year. And the priest will be one priest per time. Others couldn't continue. Jesus goes in the presence of God and he sits. He sits both as a high priest and he sits as a sacrifice. Hallelujah. Are you there? Notice, he goes in the heaven. Hebrews 4:16. He says, come boldly before the throne of grace, that you may receive mercy and grace to find help in the time of need. Look at Hebrews 10 and verse 10. Notice this. Hebrews 10:10. Now, look up again. Look up again. The high priest will take the offering into the veil, right? When did Jesus go to heaven? When he was raised from the dead. So, whatever he took there was raised from the dead. Hallelujah. Are you listening now? So, let's look at the offering of Jesus. Hebrews 10. He says in Hebrews 10:10, by the which will we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once. Now, was this offering of the cross or the offering behind the veil? Clear? Clear? How do we know? Look at the next verse. Every priest stands daily ministering and offering the same sacrifices which can never take away sin. But this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, what did he do? He sat down. See that? So when he rose from the dead, Hebrews 5:5 says, he became our high priest. He was qualified to be the high priest of the new covenant, which will be after the power of an endless life. So he goes into heaven alive. The sacrifice is alive. The sacrifice is not a dead person. The sacrifice is not a dead animal. He was killed for us. And he is alive for us. Hallelujah. So he goes into heaven and he sits down. Many times in the book of Hebrews 1:3, he says the high priest is seated. Hebrews 8:1, he's seated in the right hand of the majesty on high. Hebrews 10, verse 12, he, after he offered a sacrifice, he sat down. Hebrews 12, 2, he sat down at the right hand of God on high. He sat down. Why? Showing you the finality of what he has done. The finality of what he has done. So note this. That means his offering and his sitting happen together. Hallelujah. You lost that, didn't you? His offering and his sitting down happen together. Everything happens together. He goes to heaven with the redemptive sacrifice. He's raised from the dead. He's raised from the dead. And he takes the sacrifice, a living one, to heaven. A living one. And that sacrifice is his glorified self. He goes to heaven. He is the high priest. He is the offering. Both at the same time. If he had to offer something else, that means he needed an offering before God. But he is the offering for us. And he is the high priest for us. Everything he did it for us.
us manifestations. These are times of mighty manifestations.